Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace Aleya from toleratedcinematics.com, and today it's Filmmaking Friday. Alright, so this Monday I made a video for Adobe After Effects Master Properties, the new update from April 2018, and now I'm going to be talking about a Premiere update also from 2018 April, an amazing cool new feature they added in the color grading for Adobe Premiere Pro, and it allows you to match colors very easily to your other scene, whether it is your own video that you have already graded and then you want the other scene to look kind of similar, then you can just do this completely automatic. But I took it a step further. I looked up some scenes from real movies that I really enjoyed, and the colors were very kind of unique for those kind of movies. So now I'm going to use those movies as a reference to apply it to my own video. So let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and see how it's done. Alright, so here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro. I'm going to be using some of my footage from a vlog. Pretty cool footage to apply some grades on. So this is what I have. This is completely gradeless. So here we want to apply some kind of grades that are similar to movies. So the first movies that popped in my head with a unique grade were these kind of images right here. One from Transformers, and then one here from Mad Max, and one here from Dunkirk, and here from The Matrix. So I'm just going to drag these into my timeline. This is necessary in order to achieve this effect. You have to add reference images in your timeline, so you can do whatever image. It doesn't matter if it's a photo, a video, doesn't matter. Before we continue this video, I would like to present you our website designed for filmmakers and video editors to improve their workflow. We offer templates, presets, high quality pre-made packs, soundscapes, essential graphics, and much more. If you don't have time to create something of your own, or you just want to speed up your workflow, definitely check out our website with the link in the description below. So what do you want to do next is you want to go to those frames and make sure that they fill the entire screen. So right here, I'm going to zoom into this scene. This also just make them fill the screen here. And then for this one, this has this the Transformers has the letterboxing. We also want to kind of get rid of that by increasing the size here. And there we go. So now we have some kind of different colors. Ideally, you're trying to look for scenes that have a lot of variation going on. For example, the Dunkirk scene actually looks very similar to the footage that I have, because it was actually also filmed partially in Belgium, I think. But the houses and the streets, they look very similar to that scene from my vlog, for example, right here. So you can see that it's pretty close. So that is probably going to work best in my case. So it really depends what kind of footage you are using. Not everything is always going to work out very well. Try to look for different kind of shots with a similar kind of grade and see which one works best for your video footage. But let's go into my video here. So for the Mad Max, for example, we have here a close-up of the face. So what we'll do is go for a close-up on my face, maybe this one right here. And then we'll click on that video. I also applied a kind of letterboxing to make it a little bit more cinematic. Also, I recently made a tutorial on animating those letterboxes in, which is a really cool and popular style in vlogs. So definitely go and check that tutorial out if you haven't already. So let's continue with this tutorial right here. Let's go to the Lumetri color. If you don't see that, you can go to Window, Lumetri color right here, or change workspace to color workspace. Or right here, you just click color. Okay, so we are in the Lumetri color and you have all these tabs, and the new update actually is in the color wheel and match. So they added this match button, and that is because you can now click on comparison view, and that will allow you to actually play back in your timeline on the other reference image, and this is going to be used, as it says, as a reference. So what I will do is just put my letterboxing a little bit up, and then I will create a new adjustment layer, click OK, and bring this on top of my video footage right here. Click on that video adjustment layer and go to the Lumetri color and click on comparison view. Now we can scrub through our video again like so, and you will see that we're just watching at our own video, and at the end we have our frames from the video footages. For example, you want to use this one, click the apply match, and that's all you gotta do. So there we go, and it looks quite similar. It's not perfect because at the sky. And there we go, so we have quite similar colors right now from Mad Max. So that's a pretty cool way to do this. Let's continue in our video and look for another scene. For example, the Dunkirk scene. I'm going to do that right here because that kind of is very similar. So apply the matte and boom, there we go. So as we can see before and after, it's a very similar match to whatever we have in the Dunkirk scene. You can also click this, for example, the vertical split, and then with this tool you can actually compare the two very closely, or this way you can also do it. So you can see that the colors are very similar from the highlights to the darker tones, which is pretty cool. Let's go for another scene. Maybe Transformers, let's see what that does. Okay, that pops the greens a little bit, so the shadows should be a little bit more blue in my opinion. So let's try again. This gets it a little bit more green from this shot right here. But maybe you should look for another kind of scene. Let's go for the Matrix one, which is a kind of legendary shot, as you might know. We will use it right here, and this is really going to make everything a lot more green. Of course, you can go back in here and add the contrast a little bit to make it pop a little bit more. But as you can see, it looks like a shot from the Matrix movie. Maybe increase the highlights just a touch. Okay, so pretty cool. Always go back into the basic correction to kind of finalize your video. Okay, I have one more shot here that I'm also going to add right here from James Bond. I'm also going to scale this up. And the reason why I'm going to try this shot is actually it has the same kind of weather conditions as my shot. So actually also very important is to try to find a scene that has similar kind of lighting conditions from your shot. So try to make it as close as possible, and then the matching is going to be as close as possible also. For example, this shot, and we'll do this with the James Bond feature. Match it and actually make sure we're using the adjustment layer here, and there we go, we can see that the orange tones are very similar here. So that's a great job. It does an incredible job in my opinion with all the information it only has. It's kind of matching the shots pretty close. Of course, it's not always going to have the most perfect job, but in most cases, this will be the tool that you need. For example, if you have two different kind of shots with two different cameras, and you want to bring them together, make them look similar, this tool is going to help you out for sure. It makes your job so much easier instead of doing everything manually. So great job, Premiere Pro, to do this update. I really love it. I hope you love it as well. And if you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel for more. And definitely check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers, motion graphics artists. And if you buy something, it helps to support the channel. Hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.